Mark, good morning.
Good morning, Rob. It sure is Feel Good Friday, isn't it?
It is.
It's going to be a green Christmas. That's okay.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that.
I think we could deal with that, right?
We can. Everybody is mostly in agreement, I think.
Mostly in agreement.
Well, there's always some people that would like a little dusting or a sprinkle.
Yeah, that would be nice. Maybe roll up a snowman.
Yeah.
A couple snowballs. Throw them around, run around. There is something about the white Christmas.
There is, sure. Especially when you're a kid and you get a sled.
Mm-hmm.
Think about all the times you got a sled or one of those inflatable snow tubes and you can't use it.
Oh, I know.
You're like,
as opposed to the vision of putting on those moon boots, the snow pants, and running to the hill.
Oh.
Running, feeling that cold air smashing you in the face. It's wonderful.
When you're a kid, you can spend a lot of time in the cold, it seems like.
Not so much as an adult. I enjoy it. I like the feeling.
That's true. Well, you love skiing, right?
We love skiing. We're doing the cold immersion therapy with the ice plunging.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry. Having a lot of fun with that. 2024 is the next time I'm going to see you.
Yes, that's true. Yeah, I'm off next week, and I know with all the different busy schedules. So, yeah, I won't see you till the new year.
Have you started writing 24 yet?
Yes. Yes, I have. I forget the other time. I guess I wrote it on a couple of cards I sent out. That's why I'm trying to remember.
Or things upcoming, right? So appointments upcoming in 24.
I said, have a great 2024. So it's good. Some people I know, they love odd years or even years. So if you like even years, I guess this is something.
That's interesting. It's an election year. That'll be pretty interesting.
That'll be exciting. Christine, you're excited. That means a lot of fun things to talk about with election year.
Non-stop.
Yes. Non-stop chat, and you get it right here at WATD, just like the storm watch. When that storm hit, I'm going to be honest with you, Rob. I thought there was going to be rain on Monday. I didn't think there was going to be a micro hurricane,
but
here we were on WATD telling everybody what's going on and keeping everybody safe and informed. South Shore. I mean, even if I were to move from this wonderful area, I'd be streaming to find out what's going on
never
on South
happened.
Shore right here on WATD 95.9.
You got it. You can stream it. You can take it from the website. You can put the little Odyssey app on your smartphone. That's what I do.
Odyssey. That's a good one.
A-U-D-A-C-Y. And then you just punch up WATD and the little app comes up.
And you get this real local information, which is such a rarity.
Yeah, it's great to take WATD with you. You can take WATD in your pocket now.
Yes,
it's amazing.
You can. Listen all right. All day.
Listen to that little
I heard you all talking about the movies and the songs on the way in. I was so excited. I was thinking about that on the way in, if that was something we could talk about. And you had people going about it. And some of the callers in, Father Christmas by the Kinks.
Yep.
Such a great Gen X Christmas song right there. The Kinks.
Yep, we had several votes for that. We just had someone, Paula from Scituate, said, my favorite Christmas carol was Christmas Bride. Does anyone remember Christmas Bride?
Mm-mm.
An old one by the Ray Conniff Singers?
Mm-mm. I love that Chuck Berry one, too, Christine.
Oh, that was Pete from Hingham. Isn't that great?
And you saw him live. I love that.
I did, believe it or not, like back in the 70s at Steel Pier in Atlantic City, and then in Philadelphia at the Spectrum during one of those oldies concerts. What a show he put on. Still doing the duck walk.
I love it. My son Timmy, it would be completely jealous of that. He loves Chuck Berry.
He was terrific.
Run, Rudolph, run.
You know, I told Rob, one I forgot about that I'm just getting into is on that new Amazon commercial where the guy buys a speaker and he puts it in the barn and the llamas are dancing and you hear this voice come on, Mamacita, ¿dónde está Santa Claus? And the llamas are there dancing around. I know that I'm doing a very bad rendition
of it.
No, it
was great.
But it's a really cute commercial and I like the song. I think is it from the 60s, Rob? Something like that?
I think it must be. I'm not sure.
I don't know that one.
What's the most famous version of that? Does anyone know?
I think it maybe Los Angeles. Isn't that where the guy was from? Del Rio or Rayo? But I hadn't heard that in years.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
Is this it?
Mamacita.
This is it. Okay.
Yes.
¿Dónde está Santa Claus?
Okay.
Picture the dancing llamas.
As your dancing llamas going left to right on your radio.
I'm going to need to add this to my playlist, my Christmas playlist.
Okay, that's a good one. All right. Thank you, Christine, for reminding us of that one. We'll put that on the list. Lisa from Marshfield wanted to say Mariah Carey and Baby Please Come Home version by Mariah Carey.
Sure.
And for
U2 does a good version of that.
Yeah, we had actually several votes for the U2 saying that is the best version, and then we had a few people now saying the movie cartoon version only of the Grinch
for the movie.
Yeah, for not the live version, but the cartoon version.
You know what song, as the years go by, is really hitting my soul is that All-Star Band-Aid song, Do They Know It's Christmas?
Oh, yeah.
Right.
Where those superstars from the early MTV era, that early
coming together.
80s, coming together to feed the world. Yeah. And when you listen to it, I mean, there's solos from the artists. It's really special, and I've been noticing that over the years that is made its way to the top of my list. You know, Bing Crosby and David Bowie always were from childhood on. The Little Drummer Boy was always my favorite.
I've always been still fascinated by that combination because it's
so
one
great.
That most people would never think would happen, and yet it did, and it was just perfect.
And I think that's what makes it so special.
Yeah.
Right? That the whole setup, when it's almost like he's at Mr. Rogers, you know, opening
the
door.
Yeah, I mean, you got
David Bowie,
and then you got Bing over there, and he's got his pipe, you know, and it's just like a totally different kind of...
generations. They were different generations, and they were explorers for each of their generations, for sure. That's it.
Oh, that's the Band-Aid, Do They Know It's Christmas. And that's that important message, and we still have people that are going hungry in 2023 and 2024, and we know that there is plenty of food to go around. It's just trying to get it to the people that need it. So that's still an important message.
And it is the message of the season, and this is why, you know, I know that not everybody celebrates Christmas. For me and my family, it was a really important holiday.
Yeah.
And it was magical. It was really important to our father. And he really showed the giving is what makes the season. And you would see, and I mean, some of my fondest memories are around the Christmas tree where he's delivering the gift, and you could see the pride and the wonderment in his face. And it is so important to remember that because of that people are in need here.
Yeah.
And we must continue to remember that. And it feels really good to be able to help and to give. And that's that giving of gift, right? Which is why I think Christmas is so special for me and my family. And again, I know not everyone celebrates it. However, I do feel there's an energy in the air around this time of year, every year, where, you know, people come together and they show gratitude.
Yeah. I mean, there are a lot of parties. A lot of the parties that are going on are for charities. There's things about, you know, just getting together. Yes, seeing your friend and having a beverage, but also, you know, getting toys or whether it be coats or food or whatever it is. People love to get together and they do good, and people decorate and they sing. And there's that wonderful, there is kind of that spirit that you do get this time of year that I love so much that sometimes you wish that feeling wouldn't go away.
Well, we work at it. Practice every day, right? Practicing gratitude is one way of helping it. But you bring up a good point with the giving. And this year, you know, shout out to my friend Glenn Grant, who said, are you still collecting for Toys for Tots a couple weeks ago? And what his family does is when they receive a gift for their kids from grandma or aunts or uncles that they know that the child is not going to use or that they already have and it's a duplicate, they stock it away in the closet for the following year to give to Toys for Tots. So folks, if you're hearing this, you know, don't unnecessarily open something that you know your kid's not going to use, and maybe don't bring it back to the store. Put it in the closet, and we'll be collecting because we're here, 2024. We'll be collecting for Toys for Tots again next year, and bring them by. And somebody would love that gift.
The regift reminder.
The regift. The regift from Seinfeld.
Yeah, that's important. That's important. Well, yeah, we think about all the different gifts there can be. A lot of people, again, you know, for the kids, it's, of course, it's about toys. Who doesn't like ripping open a present? Or maybe it was so big and it just was like, you know, like for me, it was the wagon under the tree with like a bow or something. That red metal wagon. I loved that thing. It was great. I used to take my sisters out there, and that's when I invented my own ride for my two younger sisters, and I thought I could extend the wagon by putting an upside down sled on it, which would be like seats. So I made it, and it had little rails on the side for them to hold on to. The only thing I didn't think about is I didn't attach the sled to the wagon. There was nothing holding it. So when I made them go around the corner very fast, the sled would fly out, and they would fall down.
They would fly out?
Yep, they flew out.
Oh, my goodness.
Radio flyer.
Yep, radio flyer.
So question for you.
Oh, yeah.
And for the listeners, does Santa rap or not rap? So in the morning when you woke up and Santa came.
Santa brought that one.
Yeah.
He brought that. He didn't rap. No. That was Santa brought that sled. I keep calling it a sled. It was for my sisters, but it was a wagon.
So Santa didn't rap in your house? Yeah. No.
Both.
My house either.
Both.
Really?
Yeah. Both.
I guess it depends.
Because some of the big, like the year I got my Patty Playpal doll, the size of a real kindergartner, she was standing by the fireplace.
Wow.
But some of the smaller ones were wrapped.
Interesting.
Okay.
Yeah, everybody does Christmas a little bit different. Everybody approaches it differently, and everybody's coming together around this time, which is so important and so lovely, and cherish each other, you know, squeeze them tight with those hugs, give them a good squeeze, and you know what we talk about a lot is you know, impact the energy. You know, you don't have to simply accept the energy in the room.
Yep.
Affect change, right? If the room is talking about woe is me, World War III, and the economy, blah blah blah, don't sit down and join in. Change it. Change the conversation and impact that energy to inspire and keep going and keep that Christmas magic in the air. No politics this holiday season, folks. No politics.
Probably a best, good idea, best practice for that.
Great idea.
Best practices. This is a no politics zone.
Yeah. All right, so toys for kids. We love that. We love some people like for presents, experiences, having time, or, you know, some kind of destination type of thing. Like, you know, here are two tickets. Mark, you know, let's go take in, you know, a show or something like that. Or maybe it's some people really do love gift cards. You know, as my nephew gets older, it's no more toys now. As his voice is changing, it is now also his taste in things are changing, and now he wants gift cards.
Gift cards are great.
Which is fun. It's fun, but it's not as exciting to wrap up or open. But
it's a gift. It's a thought. It's a you go get what you want.
It's what
right?
he wants. It's what he wants.
Yeah.
So Kellen is slowly growing or fast quickly growing up.